Hi, everyone. My name is Artad Gregg, and along with my friend and colleague and associate conductor, Mr. Sean Deskin, we are excited to invite you to the 32nd year of the North Pittsburgh Symphonic Band Concert Series. The concert itself will be on Sunday, October the 20th at 3 p.m. in the North Hills Middle School Auditorium, and we hope that you'll come. We hope that you'll bring some friends as well. We're further excited to launch this new series of pre-concert concert talks. And in these concert talks, we try to provide some information about the pieces that we'll be performing that might pique your interest, might be of interest to you to find out a little bit more about the composers or a little bit more about the pieces. Some which may be familiar to you and some which may be new. And we hope we cover the gamut of both. We try to program a variety of music in each concert so you'll find something that speaks directly to you and maybe something new to help inform you. So we open up the concert series and our concert year with something that would be akin to what you might hear at the beginning of an opera or the beginning of a musical, kind of an overture form. In the band realm, this was written by Alfred Reed. Alfred Reed, prolific writer for wind bands. Punchinello, Hounds of Spring, Russian Christmas music, Festival Prelude, just to name a few of the multiple pieces that he wrote. This one a little bit more obscure, written in 1990, and it's called Curtain Up. And it's a great way to start a concert season in that it provides, like an overture, little snippets and bits and pieces of different styles of music. Now, it doesn't quote any particular musical or opera. It's all original music, but it is comprised of through music in different styles. So it opens up with a very technically challenging fanfare, which runs directly, segments beautifully into something that's very quaint. You might expect from the 1920s or 30s, a little soft shoe style of playing. It moves from there into a waltz, a very challenging waltz, in one with very flowing melodies that I think you really enjoy. And it closes with a kind of jazz fusion style of music, which makes for a wonderful, more modern exit to the work. Again, Curtain Up by Alfred Reed. Secondly, we do a piece of music by another very well-known composer, Claude T. Smith. I think one of the things that we try to do with the North Pittsburgh Symphonic Band is to do musics of stature, musics that have stood the test of time. And this is one. Claude Smith wrote over 110 pieces for bands, so a very prolific writer. But this was his second piece, probably his best-known work, Imperato Overture, written just before this. His setting of God of Our Fathers is just a wonderful work as well. Festival Variations, just a ton of pieces. But this being his second work, I like to do this one because even a lot of bands people don't know this one as well. It's entitled Incidental Suite. And what it does is it gives us a little bit of insight into Claude Smith's writing. It's three short movements, three short demonstrators of his style of writing. It starts off with a tarantella, but not your typical kind of 6-8 tarantella that just flows. It has a little bit of asymmetry in the rhythm, which became one of the things that he was very well known for, was stretching some of the meters to make things just a little bit more unique. It moves on from there into just a beautiful nocturne, beautiful ballad. And what this ballad, along with just being a beautiful piece of music, it allows us to feature some of the wonderful soloists in the North Pittsburgh Symphonic Band. So just flowing melodies full of just beautiful sections that I really hope you'll enjoy. And you get to hear some of these wonderful Pittsburgh musicians play, and play well they do. It closes with a romping rondo introduced by our wonderful percussion section that just flies from the beginning to the end, which I think is a lot of fun. So within these three short movements, again, his second work that he wrote of 110, it gives us a really good insight into what his writing style was. And a lot of the trappings that he used in this piece are ones that you can hear in the later works that he did. So I hope that's informative and enjoyable for you as well. Claude T. Smith's Incidental Suite. After that, we're doing a work that was set by Claire Grundman, but it's a collection of Aaron Copland music. It's called A Copland Portrait. And we know Aaron Copland is kind of America's composer. He and John Williams just kind of defined what we can call America's music. And Grundman took multiple sections of well-known works by Aaron Copland and put them together in this very challenging but beautiful work. Many of these little snippets, if you don't know the titles, you will have heard them before. So everything from the Fanfare for the Common Man, which you have heard multiple times, whether you know it by its title or not, introduces this work in just beautiful power and majesty from the percussion to the brass. It's echoed then by multiple sections from music from his Rodeo. Of course, Hoedown, which everybody's probably heard. A little bit of the Saturday Evening Waltz is in there too, but it quotes multiple of the well-known Aaron Copland pieces and allows us to pay tribute to, again, to that wonderful American composer. And really, the person that arranged this, Claire Grundman, also a very well-known composer, lots of folk music that came from him. But this rendering of this wonderful Americana, I think that is just a wonderful. It's a challenge for the ensemble, but I hope you will like it as well. I want to take a moment and introduce a couple of the pieces that my colleague, Mr. Deskin, will be performing. So as we're late October, getting close to that Halloween season in the fall, a couple things maybe a little bit more akin to the time of the year. Sean will be doing a piece called Apollo, Myth and Legend by Rob Ramian, a newer work. And as the title suggests, a little bit of myth and mysticism involved in a very wonderful work. By a newer composer too. So we're trying to bring light as well to these new composers in addition to the ones that are very well known. And then of course, the prequel to The Wizard of Oz, music from Wicked, a wonderful challenging arrangement of this beautiful award-winning music that I know many of you have heard before, but it allows us to share some things that you know, but performed by, again, your fellow friends and neighbors in the North Pittsburgh Symphonic Band. Moving along, a setting of a work that has been set by so many choirs, orchestras, bands, soloists, the beautiful folk song Amazing Grace. And in the band side of Amazing Grace, Frank DeKelly did a beautiful rendering of this piece that is very popular and well-known. Well, there's another one that not as many people know, arranged by Himes and Maldonado. It was originally called the trumpeting version, in that it opens up with eight-part trumpet, quoting this beautiful folk song. What I like about this, not only the singular color of the trumpet, but spread out through the beautiful harmonies. The harmonic progressions through this piece are just gorgeous. They modernize it just a little bit. They provide even amounts of tension and beautiful musical release that I think you'll really enjoy a great deal. And again, a setting that even if you're kind of a band's person, maybe you haven't heard before. So I like to bring this one around periodically just to share, because I just think it's a lovely piece of music. Marches. No concert is complete without them. And I'm going to provide two of them for you. One, Women of the Podium by Virginia Allen. So female composer who did not write a whole lot of pieces, but was a conductor of great rate on her own, but wrote this Women of the Podium. And for me, it's a march that is very Henry Fillmore-esque. It follows the form really well. It's very tuneful and great one to get the toes tapping. So I hope you enjoy Women of the Podium by Virginia Allen. And then a symphonic march. Symphonic march written by Clifton Williams. Clifton Williams wrote a couple well-known marches. The symphonies would be one. And this one, Strategic Air Command. And it provides not the standard march format. That's why they call it a symphonic march. It's just a little bit more in-depth, a little bit more unique to the form. But it's very well-known, and a dedication to our armed service personnel. And I think it's just it's an exciting, again, another piece of Americana that I hope that you'll all enjoy. And again, on October the 20th at 3 p.m., North Hills Middle School, I hope that you will join us. I hope that this pre-concert concert talk has provided you some information that you can bring to the concert. If it's something that you like, please let us know. We'd be happy to talk more about the music that we'll be performing. And just remember that the North Pittsburgh Symphonic Band, as well as the other community bands in our area, are that. They are members of the community who do what you do. They work in industry. They're bankers, they're doctors, they're lawyers, they're teachers. But they share this common bond, which is the love of music and the love of music making, and more importantly, the love of music sharing. So again, I hope to see you on October the 20th at 3 p.m. in the North Hills Middle School. Thank you so much for your time and listening to me today.